Oh boy, it's lunchtime. It's me back at you again today. Taking a break, working out here by the water. Okay. What's on my mind today, huh? I think what I'm going to do is just read a little excerpt from the book I'm working on. Chapter, actually I call this chapter Sextimony, Mestimony, Testimony. And I'm really talking about what I call extensive disclosure. Listen to this. I'm going to read it just a little bit, okay? Let's see. Man in my life, I needed to get it all out. Once and for all, I never ever told anyone a single thing about me. Well, maybe my sponsor. About my good and my bad. Never my faults. Never my sexual acts. Instead, inside me, there's always some resistance to doing that. There is a balance between seeming to glorify a man's sex exploits, for what good are they? I attach weight to the rationalization. God can use even that to testify, to set a man free. It takes courage to get it all out, to run the chance of being judged and misunderstood. But I found that as I take this chance, God's grace draws me in, and I find solace in his arms, in his presence, and I'm cognizant of this. I got it all out. I admitted to it. Disclosure is in a thorough manner, my sex sins. So here goes. I've had sex in the movie theater. I've had sex outside the men's military barracks in the grass. I've admitted to sex in cars. I've latched on to sex on the staircase of an apartment complex. I've secured sex on the beach in and out of the water. I've had sex in another man's house. I've enjoyed sex on the airplane. I've chalked up sex in the mountains. I've accepted sex in a room of 10 people or more. I've had sex with people watching. I've put up with sex on a bus. I've welcomed sex on the hood of a car. I've had sex in the bush while carrying out receipt from Clifton Key. I've acknowledged sex in the church. I've gotten hands-on sex at school. I've had sex in a library. I've had sex while driving. I've begged, borrowed, or stolen sex at the lake. I've had sex in a picnic in the water on a crowded beach. I've captured sex underwater while I could not breathe. I've gleaned sex in the treehouse. I've had sex in a club. I've made use of sex in a bookstore. I've had sex in the girls' dormitory, sex in a yacht in a yacht haven while on dry dock and in a cave, in a dumpster in a girls' latrine, in and out of uniform and nude on a boat out on the open sea. I've realized sex, and more sex. I've enjoyed sex with my friends. I've achieved sex with my gay friend's friend and her girlfriends. I've had sex with my brother's wife. I've had sex with my brother-in-law's friend and her friend. I've inherited sex with my cousin. That's how I lost my virginity. And I've had sex with my ex-wife's friend while we were friends and then married. I sequestered sex with my mind. I've set apart sex with my brain, hurting a shame and in pain. I've had sex while her man watched, sex while her girlfriend watched. I've experienced forced sex, and I've even been raped by a female, left cursed out and in physical pain, forced to perform on an unwanted date. Wow, when am I going to stop having sex? And as a young boy, I thought it would never happen. Sex must be my drug, my high, my idolatrous bride. Today, I no longer acquire sex, thank God for recovery meetings and men's meeting and deep level healing. I am happily married, and now I make love to my wife with a pure mind. And I'm hardwired to her only. I want and desire only her. We possess a great and fantastic marriage bed, and she tells me God lives there. It's a bed undefiled. It took about 4 to 5 years and counting. However, today I want to talk about sex, my addiction, my preoccupation, my quest, my insatiable appetite for more, my hedonistic quest to satisfy me by selfishly giving to self and taking from you, which is my insanity when I get caught up in me. Well, I always want more sex. Did I make my point? Now, that's my disclosure to you, man. Get paper and pen and confess a thorough sexual moral inventory, leaving nothing out. I mean, leave nothing out. Find a man of God, one you trust. Pray, share, confess, and begin the process of going free. The answer is yes. I want more sex as long as I am in the flesh, so I'd better include a plan. The marriage bed is pure and blessed. Thank God for a new way, a God plan. That's my point. We live to accept sex in a sex-crazed world and sexy people that are looking for sex and calling it love. A world with sex on its mind 24/7, it appears. How does the word sex in this chapter really affect you? It has more repetitive words than a Beatles hit song. Most Christian men would probably be uncomfortable right now, and that's my intention. That's intentional. I want you uncomfortable because that's how the Holy Spirit feels when we obsess and he's living inside of us. What about sex, baby? What about you and me? That was my old song. So, in this sensual world, man, I want to comprehend, I want you to comprehend so out of depth and out of width, unimaginable. How are you doing in this area, brother? No denial. What's going on with you? Am I transparent enough for you, my friend? Let's talk. Come on, Christian guys, let's take possession of the conversation. Come on, pastor, let's recognize our value in the conversation. Come on, women, can we talk here? Come on, men's group, let's embrace the real down and dirty conversation about me, myself, and I. Men, sex, and my messed up mind, my convoluted brain, I am messed up. Sex with our wives, sex regarding our daughters, how it affects our sons and my kids and your kids and our youth. Let's talk about abortion and homosexuality, my guilt and the same-sex marriage. Come on, church, let's talk about it on Monday through Saturday. And how about talking about it in church on Sunday, the holy day, the day of rest? Let's talk about a decision, a plan, a strategy to get this whole thing about sex out in the open. Maybe then we can see it from God's perspective, from the Spirit's perspective, His purity, His plan, our sanity, my sanctity. Question being, am I just adventurous or am I really an addict? I've wondered that about that for years because I consider myself a conservative, reserved, quiet, sweet, innocent, and discreet guy. So what was this all about? I emote as one who had been to war and back. What is the insatiable appetite for sex that I live? Dare I say you? We all exist for the flesh. What am I trying to satisfy? Who am I trying to please? I used to reckon it was the gutless, the witch, the horny itch in me, or the urge to need to scratch, to rash, my lumps and bumps, all solical wounds. What happens, I heard one preacher preach, attempting to address the subject in his own limited way. He stated his subject would be to our chagrin when it hurts in the middle. We try to satiate the pain. Was that just a topic to get our attention? Had reason. It certainly had no substance other than the catchy title. Other than that, I never forgot it because of the sexual connotation that was put on it, I am told. Why is it I just gotta scratch that itch? It all begins with my thoughts, my flesh, my mind, my will, my emotions, my desires, my needs. At times, I'm a man gone insane. Life for me had become unmanageable. Trust it or not, all this was done while I labeled myself a Christian. Christian decadence was lived out, mind you, with religious Protestant, Anglican, Baptist, Catholic church girls, and you'd be convinced that I had been going to clubs, bars, strips, clubs. No, my escapades, for the most part, happened right in the church. I said that for us who expect, because we traverse the church doors, that we are safe and home free. I heard one addict describe it this way, the more spiritual, the more sexual. I give credence to the fact that the enemy's goal is to contaminate, to bring a sense of hopelessness, gut-wrenching guilt and shame, a point of no return, no redemption possible. When is it too late? When have you been subterranean, out of the way, and subquatious lately, and told no one, done too much? Do tell. When am I beyond God's reach? Can I be forgiven, truly cleansed? And what about the pain, the shame, the guilt, the ugly feelings, the secrecy, the hiding, a pretender's paradise? That can all be had right in the church walls. What about the lies? Will I ever be trusted again? Most of all, another man's silence, lost, no point of reference, other than his last fall, his sin, authority gone, relegated to the back bench and pew, and finally out the door and gone. And that's just an episode about it. Sex, my friends, is at the heart of most of what we do to anesthetize our pain. Today, I just want to share a little bit of that with you. And hey, guess what? My lunchtime's over, so guess what? I gotta go. Let me pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for men and women that they'd walk in purity, that they walk in honesty and transparency. I pray that the anointing and the power of God that move and brought deliverance to my life, the accountability partners that hold me accountable even to this day, and I can call them up and say, hey, I struggled today, I masturbated today, I lusted today, I saw three women, I had the wrong thoughts. Is there anybody you can talk to like that today? I'm calling some warriors for freedom. I'm calling some warriors for freedom right now, and I pray freedom and deliverance to men and women as we strive to press towards the mark of the high calling that is in Christ Jesus. Have a great day, and I'll be back at you tomorrow. Take care, and God bless. That's it.